Can. Yep, so and I'll move it back a bit on the So here I'll move it back slightly so it doesn't slide that much. And this contact, I want it to be to flatten faster. So I'll just copy this key here. And make sure. You can use the foot roll like a negative two. But I chose to do this. There's a way that you could do this is for the X, let's say it's still at, let's say rotation is flattened like that. But in the foot crawl, you have that. I think that would be better. So I think that's what I'll do. So for here, this is, will be, I'll keep it at four. Same thing at 25, will be 12. A whole number with the rotation zero. Same thing here. The Y, same thing with the Y. And on this other stride, I'll do the same thing. So Y is zero, translate is eight, rotation X. So instead, I'm gonna put a foot roll, negative foot roll, so you have kind of like this pose here. And but you gotta be careful to. Now you have the foot roll. So same thing here. I'll copy the value 0.8. So negative 0.8. The last frame, negative 0.8. So we can have the foot roll become flat faster in two frames. So that we have a better contact. Same thing with this side. We can kill this key. Instead, we're gonna key this one here to make it zero. So now it goes down flat in two frames. Bang. So, and another thing too is maybe this one, I'll see what happens here. If I copy this pose in translation, and zero it out, and put more foot roll in it, what happens? Okay, the key is not, the pose is not that great, so I'll revert back to my old keys here. Okay, so now here I find my knees are a bit kind of bendy, so I'm just gonna raise the my hips a bit more here. I can catch the buffer curve just to see the value. Goes up and goes down. So we'll see what happens here. Kind of prefer this before. And then it comes down. So we feel him going up and down now. So that's the, like a vanilla walk cycle. And you can add, this is just the beginning of it too. I can have it a bit more drag here. Exaggerate that more. So the other side, we'll put it at 52. So when he's on the passings, he really kind of like the foot kind of drags in rotation. And here we can even rotate that a bit more. Okay, so next thing we're gonna add is the rotation on. We added the hip rotation. So that's going to counter on the shoulders. So just something quick we can do. I'm gonna select the two controllers. So the shoulders kind of like rotates there. And I'm gonna copy that key rotation so it hooks up. Some weird stuff happening here. Why is my because we've set the hips to follow. So since I rotated the hips, see, it's kind of like moving with the hips. So I hold on. Let me kill the hips and instead, nope, I'll use this one instead. No, that's still followed. So okay, maybe we'll have to put it in world, maybe. Okay, we'll put it back in world. So let's say if I put it in world, forward, we'll have to animate this. So it's moving, we're moving in Z, 8 units. I'm just going to delete this. So it's 0 right now, and I'm going to put 8 units forward. So when we reach here, hold on. All right. Hold on. 0. And I'm going to delete all of these keys. And there's a lot of keys. And I'm going to add 8 units. There. And I'll keep this, the Z in linear. Same thing. So now the arms are still very robotic. There's no lag or anything. But we'll do that in a second. So the chest we did here, and it's easy when you're doing the cleanup on cycles, because it always goes back. It kind of like a pattern. So on this stride, we want it to be the other way. So it's like a 1.5 value on the Y. Let's say like that. More. So since it's not the hookup, we can be more we can start here with the lower one in rotation. So these will be kind of following the curve. This one would be a bit lower. So to have a cycle, you kind of have like a sound wave kind of curve. And if you want to, let's say if you want to exaggerate it, then you can do it easily too. So I'll do this one too. So another thing to read the curves too. So this is kind of slowing down, and when the slope is bigger, it's going faster and slowing down faster and then slowing down here again. Okay, so if you have it very even spaced out, then it's going to look like more like a very linear robotic thing. So we did the rotation on the Y. Now we can do the rotation on like side to side rotation. So I'm gonna go to front view. Because when you're on the passing side, the hips would be, we'll start with the hips. So on the passing side, passing pose, your hips would be kind of like that, because you're raising your leg on one side. So this would be, let's say we'll put it at 6, and the opposite. Stride, passing shot would be -6. So if you find you need more side to side, then you can adjust the X too. So new translation X. So this is my curve for the side to side. So it's going one side, and see how this is first of all, how come it's not, it should be cycling there. So X. So now if you look at my cycle, we have kind of like a bump there. So just select the handles there, and you can move it manually, or what I do is use this one here, this spline tangents. If you select those two keys, it should follow the curve of the angle of the curve or the key before. So if we go that again, so here I want to slow in kind of. And then same thing on this side, when I'm on the other side, I want to slow in, and this goes faster. So now it's a better looking curve like that. So now you can see that when we walk, it's going side to side. Same thing, if you need to adjust, let's say if you want to have more side-to-side action, then you can just scale it through this controller here. Or what you could do is you can scale it from, let's say this is the middle. To get out of this scaling, you press W, but putting your middle mouse and put it in holding down R, which is the scale, and middle click, you can scale your amplitude like that. I'm holding down R and middle mouse button. So if I do that, let's say if we exaggerate the side to side, so now he's gonna go woo, to the side. So this usually is happening when you have a really, let's say, a heavy set person. he's more, there's more weight, so he has to go to one side longer, more distance, and then go to the other side more distance. So there's more side to side. But I think we can go a bit more. I think I'm just going to collapse this. You can go to the key where he's on the passing pose and see what will give you the result. I think that's good. And by exaggerating that, I can so this my hips rotation. So this curve is gonna look something like the other ones too. So and this one, very similar. And this one up. And same thing here, I'm just going to select these keys and spline tangent. And just make sure it's a good curve. So it's, you don't have any pops or anything. So from that, we can now adjust the other spine rotations. So let's say here, this one, I want to follow a bit. So in the passing position, I'm going to add a bit of rotation like that. On the Z, so let's say 2 degrees. And on the other side, -2. So now I want like a C curve or an S, say, so it looked balanced on this. So here I'm gonna rotate that a bit, -2, and this one, -1. I'd say -2. And going to the other passing position two will be 2 and 2. So now you have, it's getting more and more organic now. So now this on the Z rotation, I want to fix this funky curve right now. So make sure it's gonna cycle well and there's no pops or anything. Same thing, I'm gonna spline that, spline tangent. And the next one here too. Same thing. And then a spline tangent, this one. So it cycles. Okay, and check like if the curves are nice and okay. So now if we just look at the spine and the hips, it's counter, it's balanced. So next thing would be the arms. In second thought, I think maybe, yeah, well, I think it'd be better if, because it's going to drag. So going to have a quick adjustment here. Same thing with that. Yeah, maybe I don't want to do it too side to side like the Z, maybe. I find he's going too like really wobbly. So maybe this one I'll tone it down a bit more. Same thing with this one. It back up, and I'm just going to tone it down so it's not doing a very kind of wobbly less a bit of rotation, more on the Y, but less on the rotation on the Z. Yeah, and maybe I'll tone down the side to side to go back to the original one. It's more kind of normal kind of walking. Okay, so now the spine is done. The head will keep it like that for now. But usually when you're walking, when you made the contact, your head would kind of go down and then back up, go down and back up. But for this exercise, I'll keep it as is. For the arm swinging, the arm swinging forward is a bit further when you're in walk cycle, then the back swing. So I'll keep this. So I'll keep the rotation now for the arm, the upper arm, but for the forearm, I want it to have a bit more lag. So I'll check my motion here. So he's dry. This should be kind of falling. There should be a bend. Still a bit bend. And then here would be kind of almost straight, and then straight, and then it starts to bend again. This one, I'll copy the first frame. So this one, maybe we'll rotate. We'll keep it more. So when you're doing this lagging animation, like let's say for this forearm, you will see the pattern emerge from these keys. And it's easier to, so this is when we want to take your SRT, the global, and we're going to put it and minus 8. So we're gonna keep it in a treadmill kind of and we can see better like the arm swing. So we'll do one side and we'll try to copy it to the other side. So here it's going to be bending more because it's lagging. Same thing with here. Like that. So when we talk about breaking of the joints, this is like the breaking of the joints here. So here, we can even maybe put like a real breaking of the joint, which is here. Exaggerate it a bit more. This one will and this key. We'll try to kind of smoothen it out. Now we start to see the lagging. The shoulder, the forearm should be start to have like a lag too at the beginning, because when you're moving your chest, your shoulder should be lagging too. But you can do that. You should do that before, and then do the forearm after. But for this one, we're just going to be like a simple walk cycle. So we'll just do the arms more simply. There's a chest here too. I just noticed the rotation. This last controller will probably have to rotate it more. So we have the shoulder rotating too. So, but we'll do that once we copy this animation to the other side. So now we're going to copy this animation, just the X to the other side. So we can do, actually we'll do it through the graph editor. Control C and select the other side. Or Control C. Oh, that didn't go. Let's do that again. Control. Hold on. Let's try it. Copy. How can I stop doing that? Okay. Plan B. I'm gonna do copy. So we'll have to do an offset of this one here. So this is when the Animbot comes in, and because you can offset this easily without moving the keys, because we'll have to move the keys here. So I'm just gonna copy these keys. Copy. And paste it. So we have like a double amount of keys here. We still have the walk cycle. I'm going to offset it now, like so. So now it's the opposite side now. So now it's kind of moving correctly with the arm. And then I'll delete these keys because we don't need them. The extra keys there. And I'll spline tangent this. Cycling, okay. So there. It's not the perfect, this still has a lot of tweaking to be done, but this is very a very simple walk cycle that you can create. Maybe it took me longer than I thought it would be, but this is like a fast way to do a walk cycle. It's very mathematical, technical, but if you follow like the kind of like the recipe, then you should be able to do a walk cycle. And there's two types of walk cycle that you can do, like going forward, which what I did, and this one, I'm going, once I'm happy with my walk cycle, and this is like all all kind of like tweaked and everything, then I can keep I can bake the animation, and I can show you in a second. So I'm just gonna save this as save as walk cycle forward. Okay. So let's say you have a walk cycle and you're happy with it. We got the treadmill happening because we animated the SRT here. But you want your animation to be in a treadmill, and you can use this and put it in a path, let's say the SRT, put it in the path, and with the value of your walk cycle that you know already, which is 8 units per cycle, you can quickly do a walk cycle in a path, let's say turning and everything. For sure there's going to be a bit of sliding, you'll have to tweak it, but it'll be much easier to do. So well, from the walk forward, we're going to bake the animation into like a treadmill kind of walk cycle. So we'll continue with that. I'm just going to save this version as, we'll see TM as treadmill. Okay. So now I'm going to so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make this actually I'm going to move this much, because what we're going to do is derive the position of the foot, the 2 feet, and the COG. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these three. I'm just going to place it more in the center of the COG. So how I can do that is I can use the translate, all the translate, the three translate, and move them all together. So I think it's 2 units that I want to move. Maybe 2.5. Yeah. So I'll do that. I'll cache buffer. So I'll move this. So this is all moving the whole Z together. So he's more in the middle of the SRT. So that's what I want. So now he's still moving in a treadmill. And we're going to extract the the position of these three controllers. The reason I want to do that is because I want the animation of all the frames when he's in treadmill. So and we're going to kill the animation on the SRT. Okay, so what we'll do is now is I'm going to create a locator. Let's show locator first. I'm just going to put one here, duplicate this one on this side, and duplicate another one for the hips. So I'm going to I'll do a constraint parent, but with maintain offset unchecked. So when I do that, apply, it's it's a constraint there to the pivot. Same thing with this. Same thing with the COG. So now they're all going to be following the feet and the COG. So now I'm going to select all the locators and I'm going to bake them. There's some plugins that you can bake in Animbot. It's like a cupcake, but I'll do it the old school way. So keys, I'm gonna have those locators selected, and I'm gonna say bake keys. Bake simulation? No. Yeah, bake. I just want to see bake selected, all keyable, time slider. So it's going to bake from 1 to 25. So say bake. So you see all the information now is in the locators. Okay. So now I'm going to delete this animation here now. Delete. Oops, sorry. Undelete in first frame. Delete the keys. So now he's in the middle. That's what we want. Because let's say if we want to control it through the SRT, then we want it to be in the middle. So now we're going to do the reverse, which is we're going to constrain it to the locator, the feet, let's say. So I'm going to select, it doesn't matter if we have keys on it, so because it's after the fact that when we constrain it. So here I select the locator first, then the foot controller, and we'll say constraint. So now it's going to be following it's going to be following there. Ignore that because my COG is going forward. That's why it's screwing up. Okay. So I'll do the same thing with this one. constrained parent, and finally the COG. Constrained parent. So now I have him doing a treadmill walk. Okay, so now we do the reverse. We're going to bake these controllers, and then we can flush the locators after. So now we can delete the locators. So delete that. And now we have the walk. So now that we have it, we can still control it. We know the value of the speed. So it is going to be 8, but it's always going to be in linear. So we just reverse the value, that's all we did, and it's not sliding. Okay, so let's say if you want to put it on a path with a curvy path, so let's create a curve. So let's say from here, say he's walking in a circle. So now we can put him on a path. So I'm going to select the SRT, then the path, and then constraint motion path attached to path. Don't have anything. Okay, I have a key here, so not a good idea to have a key there. Straight motion path. So now but he's facing the other way, we can change that. Let's go in. But you can we'll undo it. It's easier to do it on constrained path with the options. So facing forward would be the Z. So front axis will be the Z. Up axis is going to be the Y. And then we'll say apply. So now he's in the path. So he's going a bit fast, and this curve needs to be linear since our speed is linear. So he's going super fast, so we can adjust this curve to fit the animation. So here, I'm going to actually this is this won't work because it's too we need more frames. So let's say 200 and this will be stretched more. Let's say something like that. Because this curve is the value of where he is on the curve. So we gotta zoom in. So frame 2 is still sliding, so we gotta slow it down a bit more. So something like that. You can calculate the, actually no, you can't calculate the speed on the curve because the curve value on the path is from this frame to that frame. But you can kind of eyeball it to see if you're going to have sliding or not. So now there's still a bit of sliding. I can tweak it a bit more. There. Last time. It stops there because we can continue that curve. Like that. So it'll go all the way to the end of the curve, which is longer. So there you go. So if the curve is not very drastic, then you can really get away with minimal sliding. But let's say if it's a really change the direction, then for sure you'll need to do a lot of more tweaking for the sliding stuff. Okay, so that's it for this demo. If you have any question, if you come, you can mail me if you want, and I'll try to get back to you. Okay. Thank you very much.